Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video I will show you how to set up and install DT2DB Bridge add-on which I released a few days ago. So without wasting any more time, let's get started with the installation process. So for the installation you are going to need these two files. You can get this file from my Gumroad page. This is the add-on file, and the next file you are going to need is this Dream Textures installation file, which you can get from the GitHub page. You can go to this latest release section. You will need this latest 0.0.9 version to work, and you can get the file from here. Note that this is a 7-zip file and you will have to unzip it to get the actual installation zip file. Once you have these two files ready, you can move on to the Blender, and now let's install it. So let's first install the DT2DB Bridge add-on. Once it is installed, let's enable it, and next let's hit this install DeepBump button, which is going to download and install the DeepBump add-on which is required for DT2DB Bridge. And it is installed. Let's click this install dependencies button. It will take a few seconds depending on your internet speed again. Okay, so it is installed. Now let's install the Dream Textures add-on. Let's install this. This can take some time as it is a very big file, around 4 GB. So let's wait. So it is installed. Now let's enable it. And from here you have to download the Stable Diffusion version 1.4. So let's search here. Okay, so here you can find this version 1.4 file and hit this download button. It will take some time as it will download some extra libraries as well. So let's wait, and I will be back with you in a minute. Okay, so now that the installation is complete, now we can finally use the add-on. Let's go to the shading tab and let's enter rendered view. Okay, so now in the site tab you will find this DT2DB Bridge add-on, and let's type in a prompt. Let's type wood floor, and it will give us some suggestions. So let's select some of these and switch it to 5/112. And let's disable metallic because wood won't have metallic map. And now let's hit the generate button, and it will start generating in a few seconds. Okay, so the generation has started, and let's hope it's good. Let's wait for the normal and height map. Okay, so it is here, and as you can see it is a full PBR material. You can change the settings from here, like the bump strength and all. You can even use a displacement node if you want, and it will work. So yeah, that was basically it for the add-on. I hope this installation was clear. I know it took some time, but it is what it is because the file sizes are so big. If you face any other issues, please feel free to let me know in the comment section. The links for the add-on as always are in the description below, so please go check them out, and I'll see you in the next one.